Hey guys, acquired Sugarbyte's Obscurium a few days ago, and I'm absolutely in love with it. The one thing I realized, though, is there's no real simple way to take control of Ableton's native plugins. So using Max for Live, I think I figured out a way to do that. We'll just go over the setup super quick. We'll want to pop open our Obscurium plugin. Click on the Sound tab. And then you'll want to make sure you're in plugin mode, because what that does is it deactivates the sound engine of Obscurium. Since you won't be using it, it will free up a lot of CPU if you just enable the plugin mode there. And then if you look under General, you'll have this MIDI CC option here. You can click on that. And then you can see you have 11 different parameters that you can actually send out any CC channel number, whatever, I can't think straight right now. But you can assign these to any numbers you want. By default, they are 0 through 10. And that's what we want, because in the Max for Live plugin, you can see we already have our control change numbers mapped 0 through 10. And you can also see they're color-coded properly. Now there is a little bit of routing you have to do, so we'll go to Options, or View, In, Out. On the channel that we want to control with Obscurium, MIDI From, we will choose one Obscurium, because that's where we want our control change from here, and then choose Obscurium for that drop down as well. And then we will set our monitor to In. So what we can do then, just click a map button for any of these controls, and we can map it to, let's say, filter frequency. We'll go ahead and enable record mode on Obscurium so we can start sending some MIDI. See, our frequency is being modulated by Obscurium. And you can also set thresholds of the incoming control change data to get better control over what you're trying to control. Blah, blah, blah. Trying to do this as quickly as possible. We can map something else, like maybe our oscillator B level. Oop. And actually invert it too. So, I mean, that's pretty much the basics of it. You know, you have to understand how Obscurium works. Basically, anything below the poly can be sent to this Max for Live device. And once again, you click on your General tab and you go to your MIDI CC. And you can reassign all these numbers. You just have to make sure that in the M4L plugin that you set it to the same number to receive control change data. I already have something kind of nice cooked up over here. We'll go ahead and press play. And that is all controlling our operator. Now you can map any of this to anything within Ableton, pretty much. I guess to demonstrate, we will remap this to our dry wet. Nah, we'll do decay time. goof off with that threshold. You know what? We will do dry wet. So you can see it opens up a lot of possibilities for really getting in and tweaking some stuff and getting some really crazy sound design possibilities going on. And I guess also what you can do, if you arm record and you have a clip playing out in Obscurium, it will record all the incoming MIDI as well as all the automation data that you're receiving. So what we'll do now is we'll turn our monitor to auto, go all lens MIDI from. We'll go ahead and just deactivate Obscurium for right now, just to demonstrate. Well, it actually comes in on MIDI control, I guess. So I guess that makes sense. I just made this thing up, so starting to understand. But yeah, I mean, it works. Gets the job done. I'll probably try and update it, make it a little better. Hope you guys enjoy it and have some fun.